So here I am, back in the stacks at my local library, which is why I'm being quiet. This is BLA video number 4. And I decided to be a little bit different. That's because I've been working and I haven't had a whole lot of time to read books that I think that you guys would be interested in. But I did find one, and I've read it before. It's from the young adult section. I actually read it last year for my summer reading list, and I'm doing it again. This time, it's The Named by Marianne Curley. And Marianne Curley is actually Australian. So, if you're first reading the book and you don't understand that she's Australian, some of the words don't make a lot of sense. Like, instead of saying flashlight, they say torch. And instead of saying, like, flatland with shrubbery on it, they call that, bushland. And then, of course, there's the whole thing where they speak, like, American English, but they have a few words that are British, like, mum, instead of mom. And they spell things like the British do most of the time. Of course, sometimes they spell it our way. They're like the American version of the British, I guess. I don't know. Anyway, getting to The Named. The Named is written very well. I mean, it's like a normal young adult book. I like it. And, how to best put this? It starts out in one of the main character's dreams. The main character, who is a boy, is named Ethan. And it starts out in Ethan's dream, where he's remembering his sister's death. His sister was murdered by this monster. And they were, like, running through the forest to look at the blooming of this black iris, which is a really rare flower. And the monster pops out and kills his sister. And he keeps dreaming about it every night for like 12 years. And so when he wakes up, you start to see a little bit about his life now. And his life now, he's a member of this thing called the Guard, which is short for the Guardians of Time. The Guardians of Time defend time, or history, against the Order of Chaos. The Order of Chaos needs to go back in time and change the past so that things would work out better in their favor and get them more power for more money, and it also eliminates members of the Guard. So, Ethan does just the opposite. Him and his little group, they go back in time to make history play out the way it was supposed to, so that the present and therefore the future stay the same. And in this book, he's getting an apprentice named Isabel, who happens to be his ex-best friend's little sister. And the book is all about how he trains her and takes her on his missions, and eventually she becomes a normal person, you know, guard person. And the Guard is unique because each member has two gifts, one or two if they're lucky. And Isabel's one is, she has the power to heal herself, and nobody knows the other one yet, it's still hidden. Ethan can create illusions that seem so real, it's as if you're actually there. And he can also, he's telekinetic, so he can make things move just by looking at them, or willing them to move. And, they are led by this guy who's 600 years old, named Arcarian. So, gradually they discover other people who in their town are also members of the Guard or members of the Order, and it all leads up to this big battle against the monster who killed his little sister. Of course, it'll have a sequel in the end. I mean, in the end, well, kind of leaves you hanging. Luckily, though, it has a sequel, and another sequel after that. It's part of a trilogy, the first of a trilogy. So, in the end, of course, everything works out. The monster's dead, and Ethan gets the highest honor in the guard, which is the power of flight, the ability to teleport from one place to another. And he is, like, overjoyed. And now everything is, you know, back to normal for a while. So, there you have it. And the reason it's in three books is because the whole thing is part of a prophecy that foretells the final battle in history or something like that. But if you go and read it, I'm sure you'll like it. I did. Twice. So, here it is. The Named. So, go read it. Have fun. Go to your library sometime this summer. Be good for you. Have a great summer, guys.